guys, welcome to the channel. In this video, you will learn how to safely use a dummy-load for testing a high-power FM transmitter with few steps only. Like this video if it is helpful to you. And let's begin. Here are a few questions to ask before getting started. First, what is an analog dummy-load and how it works? 2. Why not use an antenna instead of an RF dummy-load? 3. How to safely test a radio transmitter by using an RF dummy-load? To make things clear, let's start with the first question. What is an RF dummy-load and how it works? In radio frequency, dummy-loads are mostly used for testing purpose. A dummy-load allows a radio transmitter to be tested and adjusted without producing radio waves. And the dummy can also convert the RF energy of the FM transmitter into heat, which is technically the job of a radio antenna. Two important notices for RF dummy-load. The first goes with, please always check whether the cable is well connected with the RF dummy-load before testing. The second one is, please always check whether the radio transmitter output power matches the dummy-load output power. The dummy-load used in this video is 1 kilowatt oil-cooled type. And the second question is, why not use an antenna instead of a dummy-load? That's a good question. It is mainly because if an antenna was used in the test, some unwanted radio signals would be transmitted, and it could bring some severe interferences with other devices or technologies. However, with a dummy-load, you can test or do whatever you want to the radio transmitter without worrying about being complained by the local radio administrations. So, how to use a dummy-load for the test? Quite simple for that. Here are what you need to prepare. The first one is an FM radio transmitter with power line. I will take FE1000C as an example. This is also one of a hot sale 1 kilowatt FM transmitter in stock. Make sure to visit the newly released video on FE1000C. Notice for radio transmitter buying. Please always check before buying whether the standard voltage of the radio transmitter matches the local voltage in your area. The radio transmitter that is being tested in this video is 220 volts. And the second one is the audio lines. Well, they are used to transmit signals from smartphones or other audio sources. That's all. And the third one is a dummy-load. Just like mentioned above, it is used as an antenna without radiating any radio waves. And the last one is the radio receiver. It is used to receive the radio signals radiating from the audio sources to ensure your radio transmitters works well. Bonus part, if you ever power up a radio transmitter without connecting an antenna or a dummy-load, here is what's going to happen. Actually, it is not that scary, but once your radio transmitter works without the antenna or dummy-load connection, the transmitter will be alarming and the amplifier part inside will burn out due to the overheated temperature caused by high VSWR. I won't go further for this topic unless you guys would like for more details, so please leave a comment below this video and let me know what content shall I create for the next video. In the following content, I will step by step show you how to safely and properly test the radio transmitter by using an RF dummy-load. Firstly, always remember to connect the dummy-load before powering up your radio transmitter. Move it right up to the RF port on the back panel of the radio transmitter. Twist it and make sure it is tight enough. Then connect the audio lines from the audio sources to the audio input ports of the radio transmitter. I use the SLR audio lines as an example. Let's move to the XLR port, one on the left and one on the right. Make sure they're well fit into the port. Except for the XLR port, USB-C ports are also available for audio inputting on FE-1000C. Already, let's power up the radio transmitter for the testing. Plug the power line into the radio transmitter, and then find yourself a power source. Press the on and off button and check whether the menu light is on and everything goes well. Finally, you can start the test and adjust your radio transmitter so that you can listen to the radio from the receiver. For me, there will be three most important aspects for the adjustment. The first aspect goes with frequency adjustment. Locate the menu for the frequency part, press the button for details, and twist it for a specific megahertz, same as the one of your radio receiver. Wait, hold on for a second. Have I told you to choose the audio inputting mode after turning on the transmitter? Not yet. My bad. Just remember to find and enter the number 2 audio menu. Twist the jog dial button and press it for more details. Then, you can pick up an audio input port for broadcasting your programs. But do remember to choose only one input port at a time on the audio menu, or you will hear nothing from the radio receiver. In this video, I picked the XLR ports. You may also use the USB or USB-A port for inputting the audio. Well, you can actually use all the audio input ports once and for all. The second one is the transmitter power output, also known as TPO adjustment. Locate the menu for the output power part, press the button for details, and twist it for the maximum power to make sure this radio transmitter is in good working conditions. Notice for RF power setting of FE-1000C. There are two points needs to be paying attention to after you entering the menu. The first point is, in RF power setting menu, there will be a display delay after any settings, which means that you may need for extra 5 or 10 seconds to see the change of real power after turning on or off the RF power mode. The second point is, after the RF power mode is turned on, the menu will display power on, and the real power will increase from 0 watts to 1000 watts. When the RF power mode is turned off, the menu will display power off, and the real power will decrease from 1000 watts to 0 watts. The final aspect is to observe whether the radio signals are transmitted. I would more like to call it as a 10-second waiting. All you have to do is to stare at the transmitter main menu for 10 seconds. Make sure the VSWR is below 1.2, and the music continues to stably output without noise. This is indicating that the radio transmitter is working well. Seems like everything is under control, but this is not the end. Don't forget to pack up this equipment after the test. To cut off the power, always remember to first press the off button and then plug off the power line, and you may pack things up safely. So this is the end of the video. Make sure to like this video and welcome to subscribe us for more. See you guys!